Hey everybody, stay tuned where Rob and I will be having a conversation about cost management within the cloud. Welcome to the Azure Enablement Show, where we're having technical conversations with Microsoft experts about some of the obstacles or questions you might face on your cloud adoption journey. Now, today we're talking about governance, and we're specifically focusing on the resource management discipline. And to take me through that conversation, I'm welcoming back Rob to the show. Hi, Rob.
Hey, Sarah, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. Thanks for coming on. Now, when we hear people talk about cloud versus on-prem, we often hear the analogy pets versus cattle when we should be thinking about our resources. Is that a fair analogy, and how does that actually manifest itself within resource management, Rob?
Well, I would say that is a fair analogy, and resource consistency is one of the, I would say, most overlooked of the cloud adoption framework govern methodologies. In the cloud adoption framework, we have five disciplines of governance. And I would definitely say that one of the ones that around resources is called resource consistency. And that is one that I try to focus a lot of our customers on and really teach them about how and why this is important. If you actually look on my screen here, I've got the five disciplines highlighted or outlined here. And resource consistency, like I said, is around enforcing practices, making sure things are properly configured, and really helping you as a customer just to reduce your support costs, right? The more consistent you are, the lower that you're going to have the lower cost or burden it's going to be on your team to support a lot of various different types of resources in Azure.
So when you're talking about a consistent approach, I remember when I was managing on-prem environments and I tried to standardize things like naming conventions and stuff like that. Is that the kind of thing that you're actually talking about here as well in the cloud, Rob?
Yeah, absolutely. So what I would say is that first talk about it with your organization around defining what your corporate policy is going to be. And in the cloud adoption framework, we actually do a great job of walking you through how to identify the business risks so you could have that healthy cloud govern strategy for your organization. So things in your corporate policy may be naming convention. It could be, what regions am I allowed to build Azure resources in? What resources are allowed in those regions, right? It could be as granular as that. So that's kind of how you have to start thinking about it from an all-up approach, from, like you said, just naming conventions to, things like just where you can place things in Azure.
So it sounds like there could actually be some massive business risks for people if they don't standardize the resource management. And a great example you gave where there was actually deploying resources in the right region. So I'm based in the UK and I might have some governance around having things in the UK. And if I accidentally put it in the US, I might be getting in trouble with the auditors. So is there any other business risks that we need to think about when we're talking about resource management?
Well, I mean, definitely making sure that you're adhering to whatever compliance or regulatory concerns or needs that you need to do as a business are huge. And like you said, of course, one of the most painful ones is that, you have a development team, and because we didn't have the right policies in place, they were able to build Azure resources in different countries, picking different Azure regions that you may not be aligned with what the corporate policy is. So that's definitely a big one there. But there are other ones as well, making sure that you've got the right policies in place for maybe approved Azure services that have gone through the right amount of auditing for your corporation. And you never want to fall into a state where you're deploying a service that hasn't properly been, certified or vetted from your security department to be compliant before you've actually put some production or customer data on, for example.
So one question I do love asking you, Rob, and I've asked a few of my guests on the show now, is when you talk to customers and see their implementations, are there any common mistakes or misconceptions actually around resource management that they make that maybe we could avoid making, if you can share any of those stories with us at all?
Yeah, I mean, I've definitely seen probably the biggest one around resource consistency on the mistake side is really twofold. One, like they're you know, you accidentally put services in regions that take you out of compliance with your regulatory concerns. Another mistake that I've seen with resource consistency is that, you know, customers are too broad on the amount or the different size VMs that you can go ahead and build. And so you see running very like dev or test workloads using very expensive SKUs, which affect you in cost, like I actually mentioned in one of our previous recordings, right? So those are very common mistakes you see around resource consistency. But there are others as well, as we kind of dive into this. Just, you know, not like say turning on centralized logging. There is great ways to be consistent with your resources, with the policies in place to make sure that you've applied the log analytics agent, for example, to all of your VMs. When a VM gets deployed, it automatically picks up its agent, right? And that way you don't have misses where you have, you know, monitoring blackouts because you were blind because an agent wasn't deployed. And I've seen that. And you know, those are painful experiences for our customers, which is why following what the guidance that we put in the cloud adoption framework for resource consistency is very important, just to, you know, put those guardrails in, Sarah, bring it all together.
That's awesome, Rob. And thanks for you for sharing those stories. What I'm thinking about is as a customer matures in getting to put resources in Azure, we see their architecture and how they design their workloads get more mature, for lack of a better word. Do we see the same kind of maturity happening with resource management the longer that a customer is using Azure for?
Oh, absolutely. I would say that resource consistency and the way they manage the resources is an iterative process. And remember, Azure is a moving target, right? We're always going to release new capabilities, new services, new functionality in existing services. And when we release these things, right, there may be new policies that you may need to put in place. Luckily, though, for us, we've done a good job in providing a lot of native tools to help you just bring these things under control, Sarah, like ARM templates, Azure blueprints. We've got Azure policy. Of course, as I mentioned in one of my customer stories, right, Azure Monitor, right, and even using Azure Advisor to help just understand what's going on in your environment and where there are recommendations for you to improve things.
That sounds great. And it's great to hear that there's some tools that can help us. If we wanted to get started, though, with this journey around resource management, where's the best place to actually head over to, Rob?
So one of the things that I would tell you to start with is to go to Azure Policy. So real quick, if you look at my screen here, I'm in the Azure portal right now, and I'm in Policy. And I've filtered this just to a specific subscription that I'm working in. And I've got some policies that I've put in place to help me with resource management and resource consistency. One of them, just to show you real quick, Sarah, is allowed location for resource group. And let me just drill into it so you could just kind of see what this looks like. First off, I've got about 62% in policy. I do have some area where I could use some improvement there. And if I wanted to go ahead and actually, you know, use this policy and say, add some more locations or build a new one, I can go and view my definition here. And my definition is very easy. This is a built-in policy. You don't have to maintain this. This is all out of the box for you. You can go ahead and just find it in the definitions. And what this is really just looking for is a list of allowed locations that I want to apply to a specific resource group. So if I went to assign this, Sarah, it's going to be pretty easy. I just pick what subscription do I want to utilize for this. I think it's going to default to the one I had selected. Let me just pick mine. If I can find my name out of it, there I am. And then, you know, what resource group do I want to actually go ahead and apply this policy to? So let's just pick my AZ security resource group. I'll hit select. I can give this the name. I can even give this a name like AZ security RG, just to give it something a little bit more unique when I'm looking through my assignment names. When I hit next here, it's going to ask me for one thing. What locations do I want to be allowed to use in that resource group? And I could say, well, you know, in this case here, I'm just going to pick a couple in Canada. All right. And so let's just select those and hit next. When I'm all done here, I could just say next one more time. And it's going to go ahead then, and it will go ahead and create this policy, assign it to that resource group. And then I'm only going to be able to create, you know, resources in those Canadian regions that I selected there. It's a very simple example, but definitely one that I really encourage our listeners here today to take a look at to get started with resource consistency. Another one, there's another built-in policy I kind of set up for us here. It's allowed VM virtual machine SKUs. Very similar to the other one that I just showed you. Again, select your subscription, go ahead, do your assignment name. But when you actually go ahead and select your SKUs, you can see here, you can uncheck all the ones that make sense so that when you assign this policy, say it's going to be to a resource group where I know I'm going to be doing some development activities. So maybe I'm going to stay with like maybe my A SKUs or my B series, something like that, that isn't as expensive as using things like, you know, some of the D series here that you can see. So I just make my selections, hit next, and then go ahead again and make sure I review and create that one as well. So there's just a few different ones in there. Those are right available, built in Azure portal. Just go to policy and get started today with that. Last thing, Sarah, that you could go ahead and look at is we do have the Cloud Adoption Framework Governance Benchmark tool. And it's really great to go through, take this assessment, work with your team. And one of the areas that we're going to focus here is resource consistency. And as you take this survey or assessment and finish and complete it, there's going to be a bunch of different links that come out of it. And if we go ahead and look, just for example, for resource consistency here, we're going to have some areas where you could focus, understand your business risks, and what can you do to mitigate these things. And you can learn more but just by clicking the link. So that's a great place to start.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Rob, for taking me through this today and showing me the importance of resource management and consistency as well. Now, if you want to check out any of the resources or tools that Rob mentioned, please do hit up our description box where we're going to be dropping links to those. And remember to tune into other shows within the Azure Enablement series.